Today, we're gonna answer the age-old question, why do I need these blue things on here? Wait, you have a Cinewhoop and you never asked yourself that? Come on! Last week, I watched a video, and I was shocked. Mind blown. If you do not subscribe to WonFpv, I'll put a link down below for you because you should be. Well, that guy's a talented pilot. So there I am, last week, just sitting around, it was raining, couldn't fly. Figured I'd go through the old YouTube feed and there's WonFpv. And he was flying in a bando area, so of course I wanna go check that out. Unbeknownst to me, he was doing something that was radically off thought for anyone who has a Cinewhoop. He took his ducts off. He then proceeded to whip this thing around like it was nobody's business, handled so well, I was like, wait, is this trick photography, Mr. WonFPV, or is that really working like that? To which he replied, increase your agility, he said. Take those ducts off and increase your agility. And of course I was like, okay. Now for a quick overview of how ducts work and why sometimes you want them, sometimes you don't. I'm not an aerodynamic engineer type person or, you know, anything like that, flight engineer, pilot. Well, I'm a drone pilot, but not a very good one. But that doesn't matter. Listen up here and I'll give you some learning. Now, ducts have been tried thousands of times through every kind of engineering feat that people wanted to try because they found that ducts can help your aircraft propellers and motors be more efficient. But, and it's a really big but, like your mama's butt is so big, big but, like that. These motors aren't very good when you're at an angle. And I'll explain why in a second, because I watched RC model reviews, linked down below, explain that to me probably about a year ago. So I had to get a refresher course, but here's the way it goes. According to any laws of physics or aerodynamics or, I don't know, clown making. What? There's a whole theory behind clown making. You don't know, you're too scared of them. The way a duct works is simple. Air gets pushed into here at a very fast rate. The propeller sucks it down and blows it out the bottom. This creates a bit of a bubble up here, which I believe RC model review said was a low pressure, and then there was a high pressure under it, which gives it its lift. So, when you're sitting flat like that, heck yeah, that works really good. It will get up there and you can tilt it somewhat as long as you're going straight. The problem with ducts occurs is when you make a turn and you upset that balance of a high pressure, low pressure, like low pressure here, high pressure down here, that's giving its lift, and you start to get into what's pretty close to a stall condition, because whatever side you're turning to, those motors will now lose that advantage of the duct and will probably not turn as smoothly as you want it to turn. Who am I to say probably? It does. I know, because I've done it 1,000 times. So the trick on these is not to make so many quick moves that you would make with a regular drone. You want to make it slow and steady. In that case, yes, this thing works very well, just the way it is. But, yo mama's butt so big, but I live on the edge, man. You know, I drink milk past its expiration date. I don't care, I'm a rebel. I live on the edge. If you wanna chase drones with this, you're gonna have a pretty hard time because this going this way is not gonna keep up with that drone. You have to get here to get that to happen. And with the ducts in the way, you're gonna get a one shot, you'll have to slow down, level out, turn around, and go after that drone again. By then, he probably finished the race and you're still out there thinking, where the hell are the drones at? Now what Mr. WonFPV showed me was, you take them damn ducts off and there is nothing confining you to the low pressure, high pressure scenario that these ducts worked under, and all of a sudden you're like, zoom, 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 zoom. He's Asian, that's what his sounds like. So there's, you know, drones sound different in every country. I then said to Mr. WonFPV, not if I didn't call him up or anything, I just put it in the comments, I'm gonna give you credit for showing me this and I'm gonna make a video about it. To which he said, coolio, which is the international language for you're a cool guy. So WonFPV thinks I'm a cool guy. got that going for me. I will tell you that my collections of drones, when they are set up in this configuration, are chase drones, just to get some kind of footage of something flying in front of me that I'm gonna tail, whether it's a motorcycle, a car, a bus, I don't know, a woolly mammoth who got out of the zoo and is running back to his homeland. I'm gonna film that.
Sometimes you just gotta say, WTF, man, and just go with it.
We will take a look at the GoPro, because we will mount the GoPros on here, and we'll also look at the DVR view too as well, so you can see how the drone is moving as opposed to a gimbal that's holding it steady. And I think you might enjoy that. Go get some popcorn, soda, you know, lean back. Just, you know, be lazy. I'm doing all the work. That's enough of the explanation and why I want to try and do this. I don't think there's anything else to explain. I'm trying to think in my head, but all I can think of is let's go fly! Well, what did you think? This is the next day. I made a lot of mistakes. I know, surprised, aren't you? And all those mistakes were made yesterday. So I came back out early in the morning before, there's a practice race up in Mango, so I'm gonna go up there. But before I did, I wanted to get this right, because for the most part, you can take those ducts off. However, there's two ways of doing it and a couple conditions. I normally fly my Cinewhoop with a gimbal on it, as you saw in the footage, and I enjoy that. With the ducts on, it is highly efficient. I can get 3.5 minutes at it, 3:15, something like that, and it flies beautifully. And I don't really have too much of a problem with the way it is, only that it's a ducted aircraft, and if I really want to go fast, I have to watch when I make a turn, and I'll have to make a slow sweeping turn instead of a really quick one like you would with a regular drone. The mistake I made yesterday was the fact that WonFpv is not flying a gimbal on his. So I had a lot of extra weight that he did not have, and I thought, Why not just put a GoPro on it? Just this little GoPro all by itself. And this is where I discovered, yes, you can take those ducts off because it flew beautifully. It was agile. You can see in some of the footage down here that I'm playing right now, it did really well, and I was very surprised. I think I need a higher C battery to do this because I'm running 75C. Probably should have 100C to do that, 1300 milliamp batteries. Because it would brown out at certain times, but I'd put it back up, you know, I'd relaunch it and it would fly fine for another minute and a half. So I got the same time out of it. I didn't expect to get a better time, but it's the trick is you can only put the GoPro up there. You can't go putting a gimbal if you take those ducts off. So discovery, I feel like Columbus. Well, that's a bad example. I feel like Eric the Viking. That's what I should have went with, because you know Eric the Red, he discovered Iceland and Greenland. Now I feel much better about myself because point proven, yes, it does work. Yes, it is worth it. Yes, it is fun, but you're not putting a gimbal on it. So, you know, put a ring on it and marry it, baby, because that's the way it works. Now, I will head off to the practice races up in Mango. I'm quite happy with the discoveries. However, because I fly a gimbal, I'm gonna keep my ducts on. That's just, it's gonna stay ducted and that's that. And I get a good time out of it, so, you know, you've got to discover, man. You've got to get out there and be like mad scientists and discover things. You got to put the negative and the positive together and just feel that vault of energy. What? You never did that?
There, I did you steady. You don't have to die wondering what happens if you take off the ducts from your Cinewhoop. You're welcome.
Mighty Thor, flying around, having a good time, flying with ducks and ducks and ducks and ducks and ducks, and I can't wait for your quacks. Swim!